Series of Britain's Strongest Man continues on Five.
Sponsored by Fisherman's Friend.
Mark Felix, Mark Westerby, Jay Hughes, Francis Kirby, Ross Stone. In 2008, will any of these men be Britain's Strongest Man? Welcome back to Minehead, the home of the West Somerset Railway, for heat two of Britain's Strongest Man. Now, this could well be the most competitive of all the groups. There's a great mix of old faces and new emerging talent, so let's not waste any time in meeting the contestants.
Runner-up for the last 2 years, Mark Felix. From Northern Ireland, Francis Kirby. A finalist last year, Jay Hughes from Kent. Back for a second time, Ross Stone of Wales. And the oldest man in the heat, 43-year-old Mark Westerby.
The action begins on Minehead Seafront, and here with details of the first event, the tyre flip and drag, is tournament referee Colin Bryce.
Thanks, Martin. Like in Heat 1, there's two elements to this power medley. We kick off with the 400-kilo tyre. Three flips. Unlike Heat 1, though, that had four flips, this is a bit easier to start off with because the second element is just so difficult. It's 300 kilos of chain and anchor, and you have to drag it all the way over the line, 15 metres. A real test of cardiovascular strength.
So what a way to start off this second heat with the medley. These people just happy that they are on that side of the rope. These guys are the guys that are going to be tested.
Our first two competitors.
And we've got the Celtic fringe to get off with Wales and Northern Ireland.
Wales, Ross Stone.
Ross Stone, who is sick and tired of being called Joss Stone.
In lane one from Ireland, Francis Kirby.
And Francis Kirby from Ballymoney. 1.80 metres.
Into position. Ready.
So just three flips because that drag is so brutal. And ooh, the flips are looking a bit difficult here. The Irishman's in a bit of trouble here. Stone getting things going. Now Kirby's on the move as well. Both of them two. One more flip, but then it's going to be cruel after this.
Three flips.
Now, just as well this isn't on the sand. They'd be here forever if they were trying to drag this on the sand. It's bad enough on the tarmac. Stone's got it moving. Keeping it moving is the key. If you stop, you're in trouble. And Kirby's had to stop there. Can he restart? That's the question. So hard, once you've lost your momentum, to try and get it back. And the clock's ticking.
Well, Francis is attacking this with straight arms. He's not really getting enough of the chain off the ground. So much friction there. You see some of the better guys, they lift the chain almost up to their chest. So it's just the anchor on the floor.
Looking to the skies here, Francis Kirby. Is he going to make it? Stone is in terrible trouble. It was all going well for Ross Stone until he had that first stop. And after
left.
That, he was just never going to make it. And I don't think Francis is going to make it either. This is as far as it gets. And all the experts were saying, this drag is going to be tough. It's going to beat a lot of men. Well, it's beaten these two. Close for Kirby. Stone just run out of gas. Now, this is the heat that produces the two favourites. And this isn't one of them.
In three, welcome Jay Hughes from England.
Jay Hughes from Chatham, just down the road from the defending champion, Big Terry Hollands.
Lane two, Mark Westerby from England.
Westerby, the big farmer from Yorkshire. Fifth
Lane
in the
one,
final
Mark
last
Felix
year.
From England.
And Mark Felix, who is hoping it's third time lucky in British Strongman.
Positions.
Second, 2 years running. Felix and Westerby are expected to be one and two in this competition.
Well, if it's anything to do with body weight, the drag, you'd have to back Mark Westerby here, wouldn't you? He's certainly the heaviest guy, but Jay Hughes...
Look at Hughes going off like an express train. Westerby the slow man, but as you say, if it comes to pure power... Oh, and Westerby's in trouble. He lost his grip right there. Felix has got rhythm and momentum. Is Hughes keeping it going? He mustn't stop on that far side, Hughes, because here comes Westerby. And you've got to drag it all across. Hughes is close to the finish line, but here comes Westerby. Felix is there. Is anyone else going to join him? Well, he can relax and celebrate. And Hughes, if he can claim the scalp of Mark Westerby here, that really would be a very, very significant start for him. And Westerby, well, he lost his grip early on there, didn't he? And never seemed to just get his rhythm back.
15 seconds to go.
Hughes is definitely going to finish second. Is he going to be able to cross that line? And he'll want to do that for his personal pride, but this is a surprise to see Westerby struggling like this.
Oh, it's a huge surprise, and Westerby just gives up there. Jay Hughes actually broke his foot a few weeks ago as well, his metatarsal, so you can understand why Hughes is struggling a little bit with fitness here. He hasn't done much for the last few weeks.
But no struggle for Mark Felix.
Mark, you must be bitterly disappointed with that result.
I can't believe it. My worst event, the drag, but you know, I've been practicing it, and they were just phenomenal, the guys, you know, beat me, so fair play, you know.
I mean, you were obviously the heaviest man in that group. Does size not help you there?
Well, it should do. I think I overdid it on the tacky, and I couldn't grip it, so I tried.
Mark Westerby comes to a sticky end in the opening event. He's already playing catch-up.
Well, Mark Felix didn't find that too much of a drag, but when you got hands that would make these look small, that's no great surprise. Now, after the break, Felix and the other athletes have a pressing engagement. The Viking Press.
Sponsored by Fisherman's Friend.
Provide communications back to headquarters. Right now we need extra medical supplies and troops on the ground. I've learned so much about myself since joining the army, so I'm doing something different every day.
Can you send for a helicopter urgently, please?
Yes, ma'am. Hello, Zero, it's Alpha One Zero.
This film continues at armyjobs.mod.uk.
We all try to do our bit for the environment. It often seems to come with a downside. New Nouvelle Soft is not only totally recycled, but is now luxuriously soft. New Nouvelle Soft is so soft that doing your bit needn't be a pain in the bum.
The Hyundai i30 won't change the unchangeable. It won't make you younger. It won't save the world on its own. But it will make life easier to handle because true quality matters. The Hyundai i30 and i30 Estate with our 5-year unlimited mileage warranty. Hyundai, drive your way.
Actually, I quite like it.
Littlewoodsdirect.com, bringing style to your door.
You're lovely to me, yes you are. We've travelled together, we've travelled so far. Your tongue it is wise and there's love in your eyes, deep and blue. You're lovely to me.
Kingsmill Great Every Day.
deliciously soft bread every day. Love bread, love Kingsmill.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. The ladybugs came to the ladybugs picnic.
We've thousands of rollbacks this summer. That's why on the weekly check that my supermarket made on Morrison's and Asda last Monday, Asda were cheaper on this many products. While Morrison's, well, see for yourself. Asda, why pay more?
If Carlsberg did goal celebrations, soldiers find out who they are in many diverse places. You only need to visit one. Pathfinder at armyjobs.mod.uk.
Sponsored by Fisherman's Friend.
While it might be fun in the sun for some, down on Minehead seafront, that couldn't be further from the truth for our five competitors as they tackle an arduous second test.
The next event is the Viking press. You have to lift this giant log up and then press it to arm's length overhead as many times as possible in 75 seconds. The weight, 125 kilos. That's like taking a 20-stone man and throwing him overhead. A huge test of upper body.
Well, it's a cruel one, this. Ross Stone found it very cruel indeed. The Welshman managing just five. And Mark Felix getting the crowd on his side. Such a fixture in British strongman, and these days for Mark, strongman is a family affair.
To win Britain's Strongest Man is going to mean so much to me. It's going to be so great. I came twice in a row. I think this year is a year for me to win. I have to win this year. I would love to win it. It takes a lot to be this strong, to work hard with the family. You know, it just takes so much, but you know, I love it, you know. I gotta do it. It's something that I really love, you know. It's great. I put in plenty of hours. During the week, I'm gonna train for 2 hours a day. I train like 4 or 5 days a week. I do 5 hours training on Sundays. You know, it's just a lot of training, a lot of hours, you know, and then to come back and help sort the family out and go to bed. I mean, when I get up like 6 o'clock in the morning, my day haven't finished till maybe 10, 30, 11 o'clock at night time. It's a long day for me every day.
People think that this is all they do, but he's a dad, he goes to work, he gets up in the morning, he looks after the kids, he goes to work, he comes home, he trains, puts the kids to bed. So this is his time. This is why he should win Britain's Strongest Man.
Oh, yeah.
Because he's a machine. Do you like Daddy being a strong man? I wear the trousers, definitely. But I'm behind him, I'm supporting him. I'm putting my money on Fee. We're gonna go for it this year.
Oh yeah, definitely.
All the way.
To toast that name.
Yes.
Well, such a proud family man, Mark Felix. Really has made Blackburn his home since coming over from Grenada.
Position.
And it's a good event for Mark. Let's see how he gets on. There's one. Yeah, upper body strength absolutely paramount in this event. And technique important as well. You get a bit of lift from the legs. You've got to keep momentum going. But you've also got to know when to take a break and try and look for that second wind. Felix has 8. Starting to slow a little bit. Puts a 9th in. But the tempo has dropped, and I'm thinking Mark might be thinking he needs to take a little break here. Right there he does, and this is smart. Just recharge the batteries a little bit. There may be 2 or 3 more in it for him if he can just refocus, take a big deep breath, Now, let's see. Has he re-energised? He's at 10. And you can hear these fans really getting behind him. Oh, just one more. He might be disappointed with this. He sets very high standards for himself. And I don't think he'd have been happy with 11 before this competition started, that's for sure.
I think all the top guys were expecting double figures, but some of the better presses here were talking 15, maybe even more was possible. Felix is 11. Now, will it stand up?
Please welcome our next competitor.
Mark Westerby has got to have a good Viking lift.
From England, Mark Westerby.
A real surprise that he was beaten down to fourth in the medley. And he was bitterly disappointed with himself. So it's still early days, but if Mark Westerby doesn't put in a good lift here, he might be in trouble. Remember, only the top two qualify for the final, and Westerby is expected to be one of those two. Now, let's see what the big fella from Tadcaster can come up with. The first three look effortless. But as is always the way with this event, you start off and you feel like you can go forever. Then suddenly you start thinking, hang on, this is hurting. And then suddenly you've got nothing left at all. But this is looking good for Westerby. He's within sight now of Felix. And he takes his break right there. But there looked like there was plenty in the tank when Mark took his break. He just looked at the referee and checked the clock. How much time has he got left? He knows how many reps he's done. He knows what Felix has done. He needs two more to move past Felix. That's the tie. He will want to push Felix down. And he's done that. And now he's going to want to make sure that nobody else can touch him for maximum points. And this is terrific from Mark Felix after that wobble at the start. Well, he's on course for maximum points here on the Viking lift. Still plenty of time left. And these fans want to see a bit more. Well, that's understandable. They're not doing the lifting. I'm not sure if Mark's got anything left, even with that tremendous support. 13 and out. Not unlucky for Mark Westerby. Far from it.
He used his legs well. And this is much better after that poor first event.
Mark, one bad event, now one great event. What's this about the retirement business, anyway?
Had a bit of a joke with Jake, you know. I said, if he beats me, I'll retire, you know. So, he's a young guy, he's very strong. So, to live with somebody like that is good, you know. I'm quite happy.
Are you going into retirement, though, at the end of this contest?
Ask me at the end. Ask me at the end, OK?
Well, Jay Hughes beat you, that's the question.
It's possible, isn't it? But I'm not going to let him.
Mark Westerby.
From England, Jay Hughes.
Well, young enough to be Mark Westerby's son. They got quite a bit of rapport going.
Jay Hughes, Chatham, Kent. I'm 24 years old and an electrical engineer. After last year, I had a little bit of recognition from around work. I work in some local schools doing the job that I do, and she walk in, it's like, are you the guy that does the strongman? The world's strongman, no, that's the Britons, but yeah. This year, my goal was, because obviously I qualified, made the final last year, was to make top five and hopefully go to the Worlds. But the qualifier this year, I actually broke a bone in my foot. But I'm a bit worried about the squat because a lot of weight will be put down on my foot, but I've tested it a couple of days ago. I got up to the 200, 250 mark, but I was fine. It was all good. But the one I'm dreading is probably the wrestling, because it's an unknown to a lot of people. It can go either way, and it's down to a lot of luck. So I'm young, I'm getting experience, and every year I'm getting stronger and stronger. So hopefully, maybe one day, I will be Britain's Strongest Man.
Take your position.
What he's got to do here is push that foot injury, banish the thought of that foot from his mind, because if it plays on his mind at all that he's got a weakness there, it's going to really affect him. So it's mental toughness as much as physical strength that Jay Hughes needs to show here. Looking good through seven. Little stumble there at eight. One of the arms didn't look too good, but he's kept it together. And he gets to double figures. And he's going very well indeed. And Westerby's 13 is coming under threat here. Has he got one more to join Westerby? Well, he's got time. But now this is where the experience needs to kick in. Take a few deep breaths, fill those lungs, get the oxygen going, and that's exactly what he's doing. He's not trying to rush at it like a bull in a china shop. He's getting the crowd into it as well. Has to G himself up as much as anything. One big push for Jay right here. Is there anything left in that tank? Yes, there is. He joins Westerby. Can he pass Westerby? It doesn't look like it. A lot went into that 13th. He's asking the question about time.
What a fighter Jay Hughes is. If he can do this, he'll go ahead.
I don't think he's going to do it, though. No. Yeah, Mark Westerby's retirement plans get put on hold for now because Jay Hughes equaled him, but he didn't beat him. But it was mighty close, wasn't it? Quite a rapport these two have got now, the old and the young.
Jay, I think you're a very popular man here. Are you known for your shoulder strength?
No, I'm not. No, it's just so surprising. I'm not. It's one of my weakest events. To come out and do that and go against guys like these, just bringing out the best in everyone, doesn't it? Thank you very much.
Well done. Jay Hughes.
From Ireland, Francis Kirby.
Take your
Francis,
position.
Very G'd up for this one.
Are you ready? Lift. Begin!
Certainly very much in the mix after that medley when he got third place, but he's slow and steady, and that first one looked to hurt him, and that's not a good sign.
He's not using his legs at all here. Look at this. Down, just a little tiny push.
Careful, Don.
Trying to push all with his arms, and it's never going to go up. It's such a heavy weight. You really have to use your big muscles first in the legs before your smaller shoulders.
This is so much technique, isn't it, as well, and so much mental as much as physical. And you looked at Francis coming up, you could see it in his eyes. He didn't fancy this. He knew this wasn't one of his best events. And I think he's stuck at five, absolutely stuck in neutral at the moment. Plenty of time left, but not much energy left and very little power left. And I don't think that's going anywhere. And Francis knows it as well. Disappointing.
There's an age gap of almost 20 years separating Hughes and Westerby, but nothing to split them in this event. Felix takes third and drops to second in the overall standings, behind Hughes, as the heat lives up to its billing as the most competitive of all.
Well, not everybody is engaging in muscular exertion. Some people are having way too much fun for that. You need a bit of strength and coordination to be successful at that. You certainly need it for this as well, the barrel and sack load. Two barrels, two sacks, they're heavy. You've got to carry them onto the platform, and they've got to stay on that platform as well. If it falls off, any of those things fall off, you've got to pick them up and put them back on.
In lane one from Wales, Ross Stone. In lane two from Ireland, Francis Kirby.
And these were the two fellas. But when the draw was announced, they looked like they were making up the numbers, and they both hated that suggestion. But that's how it's looking on the leaderboard as well at the moment. So both these fellas know it's got to be good here with the barrels and the bags. Kirby's off to a good one. But it's all going wrong for poor old Ross Stone in this heat, isn't it? If it can go wrong, it is going wrong for the Welshman. He's taken his time. And now the bags. And Kirby is finding it hard going in this sand, which really doesn't help them at all. If this was on tarmac, they'd find this so much easier, but you put that extra weight into that sand and suddenly the legs feel so heavy.
Well, we saw in Heat 1 this same event. The first three implements were okay, but when you get onto the third and then the fourth sack, suddenly all that lactic acid starts to build up. And Kirby, I think he's going to just finish this anymore, and it would be too far.
Kirby's happy. Stone is far from happy. Look at that. Had all sorts of trouble, and he's going to struggle to compete. Francis is happy just to get off this sand. 30 seconds, everybody willing. Ross Stone, but I don't think he's going to make it. So Kirby will finish ahead of the Welshman.
He can't even grip it now. His arm's totally pumped up.
Just been one of those days for poor old Ross. And he knows that's the end of that. So that brings up the big three. And what a fascinating duel this is becoming. Felix is in front, with Hughes tucked in just behind him.
In lane one from England, Mark Westerby.
And Westerby knows he can't afford to go dropping points against these two.
In lane two from England, Jay Hughes.
He's desperate to keep Westerby in front of him.
In lane three from England, Mark Felix.
And if he gets complacent, both the other guys can blow past him. Really, it's a fascinating three-way race, this, for two places. So this is a little battle within a battle here. And it's Hughes that's off to the slower. Westerby, you would think, would excel with this. Felix has a lot of experience as well, and Hughes is getting found out early. Can he make a move on the other two fellas? Because they're building up a bit of a lead. Felix is flying. Westerby's looking comfortable, and it's Hughes that's feeling the pace. Well, Westerby slowed a little bit, and Hughes has managed to close that gap. No problems at all for Felix. He's opened up a huge lead. Westerby's got himself together again, and unless something dramatic happens here, this is our 1-2-3. Felix is happy. He stays right at the head of this pack. Westerby closes the gap on Hughes, and Hughes has just got to make sure of that one to push himself into third place. So job done for Westerby. He's closed the gap again.
Felix wins his second event of the heat ahead of Westerby and Hughes. In the overall standings, the lead changes for the third time in three events. Felix is back on top, but just 2.5 points separate the top three. Join us after the break when we get down and dirty in the sand for some wrestling.
Sponsored by Fisherman's Friend.
So let me get this straight, Churchill. When I join, you will give me 25% discount on my home insurance.
Oh, yeah.
And a no-claims discount.
Oh, yes.
And the same again when you renew.
Oh, yes.
Very generous. Is there anything I can do for you?
Oh.
I see the crystal raindrops fall.
No.
Come on, Britain, for great home insurance prices, challenge Churchill.
This year, no mission is too impossible.
Oh, that burns!
Get smart.
This is between me and you.
Nurse, these people are mad.
What in the world could save these people?
These people are mad.
The new Seat Ibiza, where beauty and technology come together.
Autoemotion.
Play hard. You can always get patched up with Deep Freeze cold patches, specially developed to continue cooling therapy long after your game, whatever you play, is over. Keep them in your kit bag and whack one on next time you come off with a knock.
Bring out the natural athlete in them. This summer, collect special packs of Smarties, Milky Bar or Roundtree's Fruit Pastels and go free.
No, I had not forgotten.
I didn't tell my boss. His wife called earlier.
Time was. Forget the tickets. Not my problem.
I didn't give up my seat for that old lady. Oh, and she had bags.
Feed your dark side. Flame-grilled beef transformed by cracked black pepper cheese, black pepper ketchup, and a darkly delicious sauce. The Dark Whopper. Inspired by the Dark Knight.
I actually wanted to be a car mechanic. We broke down on the way to Scotland once, and I wanted to be able to fix my own car when I got older. As an air engineer, human technician. It's my job to make sure these things are ready to take off. But for me, the best bit is watching them come back safely.
Live a life without limits. Search Navy Jobs online. Foster's Super Chilled. Well, you wouldn't want a warm beer, would you? Big hands, I know you're the one.
This was my first ever deal. I'd been pushed into doing it. And I just think, how could you have been so stupid? And that was it.
The brand new series of Banged Up Abroad, 10 o'clock tonight on 5.
Sponsored by Fisherman's Friend.
Welcome back to Minehead, and we're wrestling with a little problem here. 5 into 2 just won't go.
Now, these guys are highly competitive. They're big, they're powerful. And I don't know about you, but I always get the feeling they'd like to take things a little bit further, make things a bit one-on-one. Well, now they get their chance, because for the first time, we have wrestling in Britain's Strongest Man. Things are about to get personal.
I forget Hulk Hogan and Big Daddy and all that stuff. This is all about technique. The way it works is you're in the ring. If you push your opponent out of the ring, you get a full point. But if you throw him to the ground or push him to the floor, it's worth half a point. So it's all about cat and mouse tactics, leverage, balance,
power. From Ireland, Francis Kirby.
And it's Francis Kirby against Ross Stone.
They
have the dubious honour of going up first.
Francis Kirby, 35, from Ballymoney, and I work for a kitchen company. It was a very hard heat this year. Mark Westaby, Mark Felix, two very good competitors, both been to World's Strongest Man, so it was a very hard heat. I'm as good as any man in our group, you know, but this year I'm a lot stronger, so hopefully I have a good chance this year. And last year's competition, I was sort of, I think I was a point away from the final or so, and I messed up in the stones. And to mess up, you know, for one point away from the final, but hopefully this year I'll go through to the final. Well, Mark Felix, Mark Westaby, they're big men, but big men can be took down, and I intend to take the two of them down. Size isn't everything. You know, you need the power. I've got the power.
Right, hands on shoulders. Ready, wrestle!
Now, let's see if they go for aggression. Or if they go for a little bit of caginess. Well, Ross Stone went for aggression and got the full point. Very often we've seen in other bouts that the aggression can count against you because the other guy can get out of the way and you fall over and then you lose, but he's kept his balance here, Stone, beautifully, and pushed his man out, and that's a very, very clean point.
From England, Mark Westaby.
But Ross Stone stays
from
in
Wales,
now.
Ross Stone.
Against a man that he won't be able to push around. Now, let's see if he changes his technique a little bit here.
Right, hands on shoulders.
Westaby, much the bigger man.
Ready, wrestle!
And Stone does go low, and that's all about leverage. Well, a big man can be taken down, but you don't need to be taken down if you can get pushed out like that, and he had no chance. Once he'd got underneath like that, Westaby was only going one place, and that was out.
From Ireland, Francis Kirby.
I wonder if the little fellas...
From England, Jay Hughes.
Took a little look at that and thought, oh, yeah, you can get the big guys.
Stand back. Hands on shoulders. Set. One inside, one outside. Ready, wrestle!
They're both going for the low position and not able to get it, so now we're going for power. Oh, good balance from both fellas here. This is a right old dance we've got, but Hughes, oh, I thought he had a chance there, but a good recovery, but yeah, got him in the end.
Victory to Hughes, 1 point.
Kirby really stuck around as long as he possibly could, but once Hughes had him going, it was always a matter of time. It looked like it was all going to be over here because he was in a bit of trouble, but then he just kept him going. And they're the big
hands
boys.
Hands on, let's go. Ready, wrestle.
This will be about power, you would think. Yes, a hands-on experience and a hands-down win for Mark Westerby. Just picked up Mark Felix and threw him to the ground like he was a rag doll.
After five of the 10 bouts, it's the small but perfectly formed Ross Stone who has a 100% record.
Hey, stand apart.
And having been well beaten by Westerby, Felix knows he's got to do something against Stone, but we know how well Stone looked in those first two. Oh, no, he went too low. Yeah, well, some you win, some you lose, and he went low against Westerby, and that leverage worked, but he went low against Felix, and Felix just said, I know what you're doing, and just pushed him down. Simple as that. There you go. Not having it. One little step to the side. Felix needed that one.
Hands on shoulders. Ready,
Kirby needs
wrestle.
This one. In fact, Westerby needs this one as well after both struggled in the first half. And Westerby's just going for brute force. So enough of this technique stuff, said the big farmer. Not having it. You're not sharing my ring. You're going out. When Mark Westerby says, out of my house, you're going.
Hands on shoulders.
Stone rediscover his form, or can Hughes pick up another victory? Stone going for aggression, and it went against him. Hughes used Stone's aggression against him.
Victory to Hughes.
And it counts as a throwdown, because that's exactly what it was. So Felix against Kirby. Kirby needs this one badly.
Guys, hands on shoulders. Ready, wrestle.
Remember, if he goes low, he's going to be in trouble, and he doesn't make that mistake. Oh, but he goes for power, and Felix is matching fire with fire here, and he's got Kirby in trouble. And yeah, any time you turn like that,
to Felix.
And I think the Irishman might be hurt there. No sympathy for Mark Felix, but he definitely just took a look at one of his arms there. Yeah, look at that. Is there a bicep problem, or in the shoulder there maybe?
Right, hands in position.
Well, Westerby knows what wins for him. Power, and this is really a classic battle. It's youth against experience, and look at the experience of Westerby. It looked like he was going out. Hughes literally trying to push him into retirement, and the old boy said, not today, sonny. This is my day. He's on his way out, and then he just knows exactly where he is and says, Jay, you're out of there. 20 years apart in age, but they've become good mates.
Westerby wins the wrestling, but just how costly will Hughes' defeat to the Yorkshire farmer prove to be? Ross Stone takes a creditable third ahead of Felix. And after four events, the overall scores couldn't be closer. Just half a point separating the top three. This one will go to the wire.
Well, Francis, I could ask the really obvious and stupid question. What have you done to yourself? You go, your arm in a sling.
I've dislocated my shoulder, so I did, but the doctor popped it straight back in again straight after the event. Whenever I was wrestling with Mark, just near the end of it, I could feel something pop out, and I wanted to pull away a wee bit, and as I pulled away, it just popped on out.
Now, when you walked out of the ring, no one around realised that had happened. That's pretty dramatic stuff.
Yeah, well, I felt, you know, just something really, and beside the chest had popped out, and I walked over to the doctor, and he had a look at it, and he just lifted my arm up and popped it straight back in again.
Well, it's pretty swift work from the doctor. Now, what's he said about your hopes of competing further in this event?
Well, they're going to take me to hospital here just to get an x-ray, just to make sure there's no broken bones, but if they give me all clear, I'm going to keep on.
So, clouds on the horizon for Francis Kirby, but he is a battler. He will want to carry on, but it's not looking too clever for him. Has his boat sailed?
Well, the athletes have moved from the rigours of wrestling on the beach to the fairground here at Butlins for the squat lift. Colin, this looks like the toughest ride in the park.
Martin, we're about to find out who has the strongest legs in the contest. Opening squat, 240 kilos. If you manage that, another keg comes in. and it's up to 260 kilos. It's then possible to do a further 5 lifts, ending on a crushing 320 kilos.
Well, Ross Stone's had a tough competition, but he made this one look easy. 7 lifts in under 32 seconds. But Jay Hughes was worried about that foot, the broken foot that had caused him problems a few weeks earlier.
Well, Jay, when you're about to do a squat lift, there are certain injuries you don't want, and a broken foot is one of them. How on earth did you manage that?
I actually broke it at the Southern qualifying round on the Farmer's Walk for this 5 weeks ago.
Is that going to hamper you?
Well, it's trying its best to. Up until now, I've dealt with it everywhere I can, heavily strapped. It caused a lot of discomfort, and this and the rest, and I was worried about, but this the most, because obviously you've got all that weight bearing down on the foot. But I'm going to give it my best shot. I'm not going to try and let it worry me, and we'll have to see if it holds.
Speaking of injuries, it's all over for the smiling Irishman, Francis Kirby.
Agony here, that's why I'm laughing.
Yes, his competition is over, and Mark Westerby, well, he's still very much alive, but can he beat his battle against Father Time?
Yeah, I think this year I realise what I can do, you know. I'm in good shape, strong. I'm trying to keep away from being nervous, you know, but I'm sure that'll hit me, you know, the last few minutes, the last hours before we start competing. But if I can just keep my calm, you know, I'll perform a lot better. I'm hoping to win it this year. That's what I'm here to do. I mean, everything. You know, from a young boy, you know, it's been my dream to be, you know, Britain's strongest man. I think if I started in my 20s, I could have got there, you know, to the top. I think it's quite possible. But we're starting at, you know, 38 years of age to get into shape to compete. You're leaving it a little bit late, I think. But as things have gone, I'm still happy with it. You know, I'm still happy with the way I am. I think the year that I don't perform as well and things start going backwards, well, that's a different story. But, you know, at the moment, like I say, I'm doing better and better. So I haven't really peaked as yet. So age isn't even an issue for me.
Take your position.
Age is just a number.
Ready?
For Mark Westerby, the numbers have added up pretty good. But he's in a three-way dogfight for only 2 qualifying places.
He did this event last year in the heats and didn't do very well, if you remember. He only managed 5 lifts then, and he's chasing Ross Stone 7 here.
Yeah, the good news for the other three, I guess, is that Ross Stone is so far behind him that even if he picks up maximum points here, it's not going to affect their little duel. But he knows he's got to do well because Westerby, Felix and Hughes are separated by just 0.5 points. So everything matters now, and he's certainly learned a lot from a year ago, hasn't he? Going for the magnificent 7 and getting it as well. Too old for strongman? You have got to be kidding. Mark Westerby has years ahead of him, and look at that time. That's not shabby.
Well, it's certainly shown that he can continue to improve, even at his age. He's getting more and more powerful.
Mark, well done. All the barrels done. Ross was a little bit quicker than you, but he's just a little fella. He hasn't got so far to travel.
Ross is an unbelievable squatter. I knew that from the start, but I knew the points are so close, you know, this year, and I just had to get every barrel. I'm amazed. I'm absolutely amazed. I'm not the best of squatters, but when it comes to it, I can really do it, you know.
Did you feel Mark, Felix, Jay Hughes breathing down your neck? They're still to come. They're right close there on points with you.
Absolutely. They've got something work to do now, though. I've set the target for them, so we'll see how they go.
Well done. Impressive lifting.
Thank you.
Well, he can only look on and wonder. But
next,
we've got quite a battle
England,
going on here.
Jay Hughes.
And it's Jay Hughes that's made it a battle. The young man from Chatham, known as a future star of strongman. Could the
Ready?
Future be now for Jay Hughes? And remember,
lift,
he's thinking about
out,
that injured foot, but he's also seen the two other guys nail all 7 of these barrels. 7 is absolutely essential, and then he's going to have to look at the clock. Remember, Westerby got 7 in 35 seconds plus change. But first things first, he's got to get to 7, and that one looked a bit tough for him. Here's the 5th. He's taking his time, but he's still looking good. How's he going to look on the 6th? That's looking hard. This is bad news for Jay Hughes. I think that's it. Enough is enough. He's not even going to attempt the 6th. That's great news for Mark Westerby.
Next up from England, Mark Felix.
And it could be great news for Mark Felix as well.
Mark Felix, the man with the best deadlift in the world. This is a slightly different test of strength, all legs.
Lift, rack out, squat.
Have the thigh strength. Oh, that was good, wasn't it? Well, fast first one.
You would bet on Mark getting 7. The question is, how quick can he get 7? Stone did it in 32 and bits. 35 for Felix, and he's on course to blow those two out of the water. If they just get those barrels on there quick enough. That's the biggest problem he's had. There's 6. The clock's looking good. Here's 7. He made it look simple. He really did. And he beat 30 seconds. He takes maximum points and looks round as if to say, is that the best you got?
Well, Mark, impressive lifting. You won the group. Is this, are you getting your charge going right the way through to the end?
Yes, I'm getting my charge all the way to the end, you know. I was looking forward to squatting. Usually I'm a very good squatter and also a good deadlifter. I mean, when someone could put on 230 kg and barbell and just squat for 20 reps, that's unbelievable. That's fantastic.
Well, it was impressive to watch, and you seem to thrive off the atmosphere of the people around you and generating your own atmosphere. Is that essential to Mark Felix, the lifter?
Oh, yeah, the people give me just loads of energy, you know. Thank you.
Oh, well done, well done.
Felix's dominant display wins him his 3rd event out of 5. Ross Stone follows his good performance in the wrestling with a great one in the squats. Jay Hughes, though, is the big loser. That foot injury means that he has it all to do in the last event if he's to reach the final. Can he do it? Join us after the break to find out.
Sponsored by Fisherman's Friend.
Protect against rising costs with Direct Line Home Insurance. Receive 12 months cover for the price of 9. Remember, you won't find our great deals on price comparison websites. Come direct to directline.com or call 0845 246 3537 now.
What's on Planet Attack, sir?
Follow me.
The heroes.
Skywalker is the Republic's only hope.
The villains.
Surrender, Skywalker.
Adventure.
Gotta keep up!
This is where the fun begins.
Oh, dear.
Star Wars, The Clone Wars.
Is this a body designed to perfection or obsession? Do you see art or crime? For our safety or to keep an eye on us? Design creates debate, and debate brings us together. The C30R design from Volvo for $14,995.
Sometimes you need a little push to let go of your Mach 3 razor until you discover Gillette Fusion Power. It has 5 blades spaced closer together to help reduce pressure with a feeling of even less irritation. Switch to Gillette Fusion Power, Gillette's most comfortable shave.
My name's Chas Wood. I'm chairman of the smallest football league in the world. Any additional coaching can only be beneficial.
Aim for the keeper.
This would certainly improve their game.
Anderson can go in the middle because he's late.
Come back, I've got all day.
Hopefully some of them can go and make it into professional football.
We've thousands of rollbacks this summer. That's why on the weekly check that my supermarket made on Morrison's and Asda last Monday, Asda are cheaper on this many products. While Morrison's, well, see for yourself. Asda. Why pay more?
The smooth running of any business is driven by the skills of its staff. But are you ignoring the warning signs? Are you keeping them up to speed with the training they need? Or will a lack of skills bring you to a grinding halt? Train to Gain is an impartial service for large and small businesses that can work with you to give your staff the skills to unlock their full future potential. Visit traintogain.gov.uk or call 0800 015 5545. Our future, it's in our hands.
All right, Tess, you been practicing?
Oh, yeah.
Good girl. Right, you ready for a duel?
I'm ready. Bring it on.
Good luck. You're going to love this one. Have that.
Is that all you've got?
Well, you dealt with that very well.
Take that. Pyrotechnics.
Where did that come from?
Yes!
That's the best one.
Victory!
No!
It's mine.
It wouldn't go out.
Beaten by a girl.
Guitar Hero. Available for Nintendo DS.
Cheese rolling, woolsack racing, dwile flunking, snail racing, river football, tiddlywink, shin kicking, axe throwing, bed racing, stone skimming, pie eating, swamp soccer, toe wrestling, gig racing, worm charming, bog snorkeling, penny farthing racing, egg throwing, nettle eating, and eaten fives. We've tried them all. Rory and Paddy's Great British Adventure starts after Britain's Strongest Man.
Sponsored by Fisherman's Friend.
Welcome back to Minehead for the finale of Heat 2 of Britain's Strongest Man. The ever-competitive Mark Felix is looking good to go through to the final. Can Mark Westerby join him? Well, he and Jay Hughes will have to battle it out head-to-head over the Atlas Stones first. Five stones have to be raised in order. Lightest to heaviest, it's the classic strongman event.
Well, this is the heat that I guess we just have to get this out of the way because the main event is
Wales, Ross Stone.
Westerby and Hughes coming up, but let's pay some respect to Ross Stone as well. A good learning experience for him and Mark Felix. We know he's going to be one of the top two on course for the final. And it really is the ultimate test of strongman, the Atlas Stones. The stones start light, but you have to push them higher, and that's tough when you're a little fella like Ross Stone. He's got the right name for this event, hasn't he? Even if he's not quite got the stature for it.
Well, he's got the big boots on, which are giving him a few extra inches as well. But for Mark Felix, all he's got to do is beat Stone here, and he's guaranteed to go through to the final, and he's done it.
He's done that. And it was never going to be in any doubt. And now here he is. Like, all these fellas just will each other on. Come on, I've done my bit, you do your bit too. There is real camaraderie between all the competitors. And Stone has done four. He's got those big Postman Pat boots on. Are they going to help him lift that fifth stone? He had to get those Postman Pat boots out of the way fast there. Lucky they had steel toe caps. And he'll settle for four, I'm sure. Well, there's time, but usually when the fifth one has been dropped, it's very, very hard to get it at the second attempt. And I think Stone says, I've had a lot of fun. I've enjoyed this and I've learnt a lot. And he's going to get a big lift from Mark Felix as well. There you go. But we know what we want to see now, because this is Jay Hughes on the right attempting to push Mark Westerby into retirement. He needs to beat Hughes quite simply to take second place and keep the young boy in his place. He has to win and then he'll win on count back. So it's a straight shootout, this. A place in the final. We'll see you next year. What a battle it's going to be, and Hughes has got the early jump, and Westerby, who's talked about retirement if he doesn't qualify, could be looking at his last ever strongman if he doesn't make a sudden move here. What a battle. Westerby's moving. Hughes is struggling. If Mark Westerby puts this on, he goes through to the final. Hughes is in trouble. Westerby says, put that retirement party on ice. Not this year, sunshine. I'm coming back for more. Well, a young boy been put in his place, but still a great effort from Jay Hughes, the man from Chatham. We're going to learn a lot more about him in the years to come. But 2008 is Mark Westerby's year. He's qualified for the final, but the young boy pushed him hard.
Well, Mark, well done. Through to the final, where you pushed all the way there.
You bet. That was quite hard. The last event, my lower back was all pumped up, you know. And stones never felt as heavy as what they did just then.
And Jay, disappointment, but my word, you gave it your best through every single event.
Yeah, a bit disappointed there. It's my best event. I've never really dropped a stone before, but I don't know what to say.
Well, tremendous competitors. Guys, give them a huge round of applause.
So, disappointment for Jay, but there is some consolation. A consoling pat on the back from his girlfriend. But that's not enough. He finishes third in the Atlas Stones behind the two marks, Felix and Westerby. And that is exactly how he finished in the final table as well. So it's Mark Felix joined by Mark Westerby in the final.
Well, that's heat two out of the way. We've got the winner of that heat with us, Mark Felix. Mark, well done on the Atlas Stones. Is this going to be your year?
Oh, yes, this is going to be my year. I came second twice. This year is my year. This is the year of the cat. So look out, guys, I'm coming.
Now we can see from the energy here that you just feed off everything that's around you. You pump yourself up, you pump the crowd up. Are they an important part of Mark Felix's preparations and performance?
Oh, yes, this is a very important part of my preparation. The crowd give me loads of energy, so I just feed off it. So the crowd, I love you.
Well, we shall see how you cope with them in the final. That's it. Six grueling events negotiated. Two men left standing. The two marks, Mark Felix, Mark Westerby. Who will they meet in that final? Join us next time as we continue our quest to find Britain's strongest man.
Behind hedges, in pub gardens and out on the hills, there's some very unusual sports and games going on. And Rory and Paddy are on an adventure to take part very, very seriously next on Five in our brand new series.
Sponsored by Fisherman's Friend.